This video shows how to create Windows 10 bootable USB using the Windows 10 Media Creation Tool. The first thing we've got to do is search for the Windows 10 Media Creation Tool. So go to Google and just type Media Creation Tool. And as if by magic, it's at the top of Google. Now, I don't want to update it because that's going to update the version of Windows that is on this machine. I just want to download the tool now. And then run the Media Creation Tool. Yes. This shouldn't take much more than a minute. Click accept. On a side note, if you're new here, please consider subscribing to my channel and click that bell icon if you want to get notified when I upload a new video. Now back to the main event. Takes a little while to get things going. And I don't want to upgrade this PC. I want to use it to upgrade additional PCs. So I'm going to create the installation media. Click next. So it defaults to what you've currently got. If you want to change it, you can turn off the recommended options and take your pick. I'm just going to click next. Now, you can download Windows 10 onto USB, but if anything goes wrong with the copy from the machine to the USB, you've got to start again. So my advice would be to get the Windows 10 ISO file. And then we can transfer ISO to USB when we've got the file. I'm going to choose the ISO file and click next. And then you've got to choose where you're going to store the file. Let's just rename that to Win10 Pro. Let's save and let it download. And just as you think it's finished, it verifies the download. And then click finish. So if I navigate to that location, and there's our Windows 10 ISO file. It's 4.1 gig, so it will not fit on a 4 gigabyte memory stick. It needs to be a minimum of 8 gig. Now we've got the Windows 10 ISO file, we can delete the Windows 10 Media Creation Tool. Okay, so now we have the Windows 10 ISO file. Now what? What is the ISO file? The Windows 10 ISO file is equivalent to an image of a Windows 10 CD-ROM. It's not just a case of copying the Windows 10 ISO file to the USB disk, as this would just show an ISO file being stored on the USB disk. It's the contents of the ISO file that actually needs to be extracted and written to the USB disk, which will make Windows 10 USB bootable. This also includes some files which are marked with attributes such as hidden or system files, which make Windows 10 USB bootable. So technically, we could just open up the ISO file and drag the files to the USB disk and mess around with setting the attributes, but it's easier to use a third-party utility to automate this process. My personal preference is Rufus, but I'm sure there are many others. So let's go back to Google. And this time we're going to search for Rufus, R-U-F-U-S. And there's the official website. It's a single executable file. It does not need to be installed. And I want the Rufus portable version. Just click on it once it's downloaded. Yes. Let me plug in a USB device. AVG stuff. As I say, it's got to be a minimum of 8 gig. This is a 16 gig drive. Click on select and locate my Windows 10 ISO file, which was in documents, Windows 10 Pro. Open that. And we're good to go. All data on the drive will be destroyed. Okay. That's it. We now have a Windows 10 USB boot drive. If you found this video informative, please like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.